Caught in around the boards it comes. Here we go. Lords ahead. Reynolds by himself. And St. John has sealed it. 1:17 to go. It's a 6-3 lead.
Six on five. Somebody has to make a defensive play to get you out of trouble. Look at Cam McDonald right there. Two guys all over him, and he just takes a hit to make a play. A little chip to space, and that springs Reynolds up the ice with the net out, and that's the reaction that the hometown club has been waiting for. Trevor Gorgie, the crowd up on their feet as Peter Reynolds puts this one on ice. Herta Bees has made some excellent saves to give his team a chance to win. And 1:17 remains. 6-3 Sea Dogs.
And it's heartbreak for Hamilton approaching the final minute of play. The deficit is back to 3.
What a fantastic job from the depth of the Sea Dogs tonight with Bizot a goal, Cam McDonald with a goal and 2 assists. A really big play on that empty netter. And you talk about your big players and big moments. You get a goal from Lawrence, a goal from Dufour, and the third line has been excellent as well.
This period is brought to you by Kia, proud partner of the CHL and presenting sponsor of the Memorial Cup.
Well, this place is going crazy now. Harbor Station, St. John, New Brunswick.
Says it all, doesn't it? The emotions percolating here with 1:17 remaining, down by 3. Everybody on their feet as the clock ticks down, and everybody has been thinking about this for months.
Costantini to the bench again. Hamilton will play with the extra attacker as they go offside at the Sea Dogs line.
Ladies and gentlemen, I got your attention for a second. You can make some noise when I announce it. There will be a parade tomorrow.
Well, they've just announced over the PA system there will be a parade tomorrow. And you can bet it's going to be a good one. Beautiful weather, passionate fans.
And Hamilton will just look to finish this last minute and 4 here with some dignity. St. John is planning the parade already, and it's all but over. It was a tough minute to get through, and what a performance from some of the players from St. John. Herta Bees, game-breaking saves. He's made a few of them tonight, and we're in the last minute.
Early to Ross, sends it around. McTavish, the shot. Rebound and set just wide. Smothered by Herta Bees for the whistle.
I'll tell you what, it's a difficult thing to do, to play out the last minute or so with tears running through your eyes, but a lot of honor in the game for Hamilton as they won't take their foot off the pedal. A late game chance, 1 turns into 2. So much emotion in the building on both benches for 2 very different reasons. And a smile from the superstar William Dufour with a goal tonight, 7 in the tournament.
Held in by McTavish, around it comes for Morrison. At the side, Winterton watches it well high of the net, out of play into the netting.
When you think about the ride to this stage for both teams, for Hamilton, They breezed through their first three rounds in the playoffs, and they ran into Windsor. That took seven games to decide the best player from the Ontario League. The best player in the best team in the CHL is 30 seconds away, the hometown St. John Sea Dogs, who have scored six goals in this championship game, and everybody to a man and to a woman and to a child is on their feet in anticipation.
Back to the line, Stales. Mason McTavish up for Stales. He's lost his balance. McTavish for the net, tipped in front. Back out of the corner. Final 10 seconds. Top down the ice. And Scott McCain and Trevor Georgie joined forces. It was all about bringing a Memorial Cup back to St. John. Years later, this Maritime Memorial Cup dream is a reality. St. John are Memorial Cup champions in 2022.
This is where dreams are made and dreams are crushed. Gardner McDougall comes in as an interim head coach for the St. John Sea Dogs. They reset, they refresh. And the celebration begins for the head coach and the players of a valiant effort here in the Memorial Cup. For the 102nd time in history, the cup will be served this year to the St. John Sea Dogs.
4 years in a row, the host team has competed in a Memorial Cup final. St. John are the first to actually win it since Windsor did it on home ice in 2017. Here's Hamilton head coach Jay McKee. Got the call to come to Hamilton to join forces with Steve Stales and owner Michael Antlauer. His first year behind the bench can't be considered anything other than majorly successful for the Bulldogs. And for Gardner McDougall and the St. John Sea Dogs, boy, it was a short ride, but what a ride it was. Gardner McDougall, the first ever coach to win a Canadian University Championship. He's done it seven times with UNB and then a Memorial Cup with St. John.
First order of priority, his first answer to our first question. What did you need to accomplish first coming in as the interim head coach? And he said, build trust. Well, they had 39 days to do that. Gardner McDougall certainly built trust. He built a plan, and he has now built respect that will last a lifetime here as he and his team are the 102nd ever Memorial Cup champions.
Mason McTavish sharing a moment with Nathan Stales for the Hamilton Bulldogs. Of course, this is the end of the line, no matter what, for their overage defenseman. Nathan Stales, the leader of them, CHL Defenseman of the Year, shares a moment with his assistant coach, Andrew Campbell. There's the captain, Colton Kammer, a tough pill to swallow, watching from the press box. And there's the third overage defenseman, Arbor Jacki, brought over from the Kitchener Rangers. He's got a bright future ahead of him, signed and property of the Montreal Canadiens.
There is no words that can make that feel any better, as these young men have a lot to feel proud of as they've honored their league as OHL champions. And there's Kammer, the captain of this Hamilton Bulldogs team, one of the three 20-year-olds that you had just mentioned, Victor. What a run it was as they come up one game shy of being champions. And speaking of champions, look at the look on those faces, a memory to last a lifetime.
There's the captain, Vincent Sevigny, brought over in a mid-season deal. He wasn't named the captain of St. John until January of this year. And of course, William Dufour, what a season. 56 goals, a new franchise record for the St. John Sea Dogs, more than anyone in the CHL this year, and puts up 7 in the Memorial Cup.
Just phenomenal. And you look at the way this team ended their regular season. They went 15-0 to end the regular season and then got knocked out in 5 games to Rimouski. What a reset. As you talk about the mulligan, they took full advantage to set a new post record, if you will, as they get the last lap and get the honor of winning their last game.
Just announcing the first stars of the game. So William Dufour takes home the first star honors. Nicholas Hurtubise is the second star. Cam McDonald, the third star of the night in this Memorial Cup final. And for the greatest tradition in hockey, it's time for the post-game handshake.
As each player pays respects as you go head-to-head, you lock antlers. And when more than one person or team wants the same thing, well, you're going to get competition. And what competitive tournament it was. Costantini was excellent for his team. Hurtubise was excellent for his. And the final handshake here before these two teams will part.
There's your Memorial Cup winning coach, Gardner McDougall, with Scott McCain, owner of this St. John Sea Dog team. So many parts that make a Memorial Cup championship winning team a reality. Scott McCain, the owner, certainly a big one. Passionate owners on both sides. Michael Adlauer has been invested in Hamilton hockey since 2002. Won a Calder Cup championship with the Bulldogs in 07. And there's Scott McCain of Florenceville, New Brunswick. We talked to him yesterday, Cabot. He grew up in the province of New Brunswick playing hockey on outdoor arenas in this province. He knows hockey in this province better than most. And he's been such an important figure here in St. John with the Sea Dogs for years. And we'll get to host and hoist a Memorial Cup with the Sea Dogs.
A grassroots start for him, talking about all of his memories as a child playing hockey, now being an owner and a proud owner at that, as he went through the appreciation that he had for TSN, for the 560 volunteers and all the people involved to pull off a world-class tournament for the best of the best, as you see Jay McKee approaching Gardner McDougall. Two excellent coaches who had their teams at the pinnacle, and much respect being paid from two excellent coaches.
So Gardner McDougall finishing up the handshake line for St. John. Let's go downstairs to Julia Tesheri. She's with William Dufour.
Say to people who had those questions now?
I mean, we worked so hard in the last months, and today we just earned what we did the last couple of months. So it's just crazy. Thanks to all the fans here, it's unbelievable. You see, they are still there just cheering for us, so it's just amazing.
What was the moment like when you realized that you were really going to win the Memorial Cup?
I mean, it's just unbelievable. We had a great season this year, and we earned everything. So we didn't have the playoff that we wanted, so we just worked so hard the last month, so it's just amazing.
I spoke to your mom before the game. Do you think she's more excited than you are right now?
I mean, she's there since day one. Since I'm born, she's there. She followed me everywhere. And, like, she's probably still there somewhere. I have no clue, but she's there also somewhere. And just amazing that she's following me everywhere. So I love you, Mom.
Thank you. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Well, what a moment for William Dufour, his mother, a breast cancer survivor, and the hockey moms and dads and parents all over the Canadian Hockey League make this really possible for so many of these young players.
And that doesn't get talked about enough, but all of the support and all of the people behind the scenes, yes, you see these young men bleeding and sweating and all the people that made this possible, but all the early mornings and all those car rides and tournaments and hotels and packed lunches year after year. Good respect paid from William Dufour to his mother on behalf of all mothers and fathers that make playing this great sport at this level possible.
Okay, Julia Tesheri standing by this time with Ravis Hansons. Julia?
Ravis, I heard that your uncle and your dad came here today all the way from Latvia. What does it mean to have them in the crowd tonight?
It's great. They've been watching all my games this season on TV, but now they got a chance to come through to the Memorial Cup. So that's an amazing opportunity for them. I mean, yeah, it feels great when they can see me here.
Memorial Cup champion, how does that sound?
I don't really have words for that. But yeah, it feels awesome. Thanks to all the fans that are here today. They've been great for all through the tournament. So thanks, big shout out to them.
You ready for the parade tomorrow? Parade tomorrow, are you ready for it?
Oh yeah, I'm ready. I'm all in.
Thank you, congratulations.
Ravis Hansons, just the second Latvian ever to win the Memorial Cup. The first was Edgars Kolda, doing so with the Edmonton Oil Kings back in 2014. Also won Stafford Smythe Award for MVP that tournament with 7 points in five games.
The 102nd Memorial Cup presented by Kia. It's been 3 years since we last presented this trophy, and tonight is finally the night where we end it over again. Nous avons le droit à tout un 102e tournoi de la Coupe Memorial présenté par Kia. Cela fait 3 ans que la Coupe reste dans son caisson, et ce soir, nous la remettons enfin au champion 2022. Before we award the Memorial Cup and the MVP trophy, we have a few words for the people who made this event possible. To our presenting sponsor, Kia Canada, thank you for all your support in the past few seasons. Thank you to our associates, Kubota, Real Canadian Superstore, CIBC, CoinSmart, for your dedication, and to all of our partners who kept this going. We are able to create these magical moments because of you. Un énorme merci à nos commanditaires, tout spécialement à notre partenaire présentateur, Kia. Le hockey junior majeur est ce qu'il est aujourd'hui en raison de votre support. À nos joueurs, entraîneurs, personnel officiel, chapeau pour votre dévouement et votre travail acharné tout au long de la saison. Hats off to the players, coaches, staff, and officials for your dedication throughout the season. To our broadcast partners, TSN and RDS, welcome back to the family, and thank you for your outstanding work during the league finals and the Memorial Cup tournament. Merci à toute l'équipe de RDS et TSN pour votre travail, et re-bienvenue de la famille de la LCH. And now, let's jump to the official presentations. First of all, the most valuable player of the 2022 Memorial Cup tournament presented by Kia. Tout d'abord, le joueur le plus utile du tournoi de la Coupe Memorial présenté par Kia. To present the Stafford Smith Trophy, pour présenter le trophée Stafford Smith, please welcome National Marketing Manager at Kia Canada, Mr. Mark Chiliano. Et le joueur le plus utile du tournoi, the most valuable player of the tournament from the St. John Sea Dogs, number 28, William Dufour.
So William Dufour, the 7 goals, one shy of a Memorial Cup record for most in a single tournament. That's the Stafford Smythe MVP trophy. When St. John won it in 2011, it was handed out to Jonathan Huberdeau, and things turned out pretty well for him since then. Islanders prospect. It's likely we see Dufour in the American Hockey League at least in a year's time.
Yeah, it's quite a tournament. 7 goals, 8 points. Of course, the 4-goal night and how important he was for his group.
It's an impressive list of winners. Dylan Strome, Mitch Marner, Leon Draisaitl, Nathan MacKinnon among recent recipients.
There are 60 teams in the CHL, and only one can be crowned the Memorial Cup champion. La famille de la LCH comprend 60 équipes, mais une seule peut être couronnée championne de la Coupe Memorial. Mesdames et messieurs, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Memorial Cup. St. John Sea Dogs. Veuillez accueillir le président de la LCH. Please welcome president of the CHL, Mr. Dan McKenzie.
Merci, Max. Quel tournoi formidable. Merci Saint-Jean d'avoir été une excellente ville hôtesse. On behalf of the Canadian Hockey League, I want to thank our fans from across the CHL for your support this season. And especially the fans from St. John for making the 102nd Memorial Cup presented by Kia so special. Thank you to the province of New Brunswick and Premier Higgs, St. John Rothsay MP Wayne Long, and St. John Mayor Donna Reardon for your commitment to this tournament. To Mark Anthony Ashfield and the host organizing committee, as well as Scott McCain and Trevor Georgie from the Sea Dogs, thank you for creating an event that showcased hockey can be a force for good in our community and bring people together. A special shout out goes to the more than 350 volunteers for donating your time and energy to make us all feel so welcome here. This event could not have happened without you. Today's game was a hard-fought battle. And I want to congratulate the Hamilton Bulldogs for their performance throughout this tournament. It's been 1,127 days since this historic trophy has been awarded. And it gives me great pleasure to be presenting it to the St. John Sea Dogs and Captain Vincent Savigny.
St. John Sea Dogs defeated the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors in 2011. They became the first ever team from Atlantic Canada to win the Memorial Cup in 93 years. 11 years later, and they win it again as Vincent Savigny, the captain, takes it for a skate.
And that is why. That's why you get up and you go to practice bruised and sore. That is why you get on the bus for 6 hours in a back-to-back. That is why you come together as a team and you persevere through adversity. It is not an easy thing to do, to win and to compete and to get better. And perhaps the toughest trophy to win in all of sports is now in the hands of the St. John Sea Dogs. That is why.
So Ryan Francis hands it off to Philip Du. What a great story he is. Undrafted into the Ontario Hockey League via the Don Mills Flyers. A year of Junior A up north, brought into the QMJHL with Moncton, now a Memorial Cup champion with St. John. And there is William Villeneuve, the Toronto Maple Leaf fourth rounder, the all-time leader in assists by defensemen in St. John Sea Dogs franchise history.
Wow, you can feel the energy and the appreciation. Nobody is leaving this building as the cup gets paraded, and it is quite a thing to be able to deal with adversity. These are teenagers, and the rigors of a 10-month season, training camp, preseason, regular season, the travel, the injuries, the setbacks, the heartbreak. And it is all worth it now for William Dufour, the St. John Sea Dogs, and this franchise here now, Memorial Cup champions for the second time.
Trevor Georgie, the general manager, played a big factor in pulling this team together throughout the season. He's standing by with our Julia Teixeira.
Trevor, when you came here in 2015, you promised a Memorial Cup. What does it mean to you to deliver on that promise?
It means the world to me, and I didn't deliver on that promise. These guys behind me delivered on that promise. Scott McCain delivered on that promise with his commitment to host, and the whole team in the office, behind the bench, all through the organization delivered on that promise. And look at this. Look what it means to this community. It means the world to me.
After your first round exit, you were forced to pivot a little bit. Are you glad with every decision that you made along the way?
Absolutely. Look, Gardner's a motivator. He's someone that can really get the most out of people, and you saw it there tonight. And I'm just so proud of the resilience of this group. They've been through so much, and for them to finish the last game of junior hockey this year's Memorial Cup champions is something that'll keep us together for life.
You get married in a couple days, and then you got to get back to work on the draft. Are you excited to get back into it?
I have a tremendous assistant GM and head scout, Anthony Stella, so he's promised he's got that all under control.
Thank you. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's a big week for Trevor Georgie, to say the least, as Jan Kuznetsov, the Russian import defenseman, takes the Memorial Cup for a skate.
What a road to the Memorial Cup for Jan Kuznetsov. It went through University of Connecticut, NCAA. He played 12 games with Stockton, Calgary's American Hockey League affiliate, then the road through St. John to the Memorial Cup, one he will never forget.
And Ravis Antsins, one of eight Latvians to play in a Memorial Cup, just the second to win it, all the way from Riga, Latvia, hands it off to Riley Bezo, the local New Brunswick product. His only goal of the tournament coming tonight in the Memorial Cup final. There is Olivier Picard of the Val d'Or Foreurs. Fell short a couple times in the TELUS Cup final. Two silvers there. Lost to the QMJHL final last year in Val d'Or. Memorial Cup champion this time around. And there's his old teammate from Val d'Or, Marshall Lessard, who's been playing with a pretty severe knee injury. And he's going to need surgery shortly after this contest. Is Nick Blagden, one of the nominees for QMJHL Humanitarian of the Year, will hoist the Memorial Cup trophy.
We're just soaking up all the atmosphere here inside the station, and what a perfect storybook ending it is for the St. John Sea Dogs. Your Memorial Cup champions now. Craig, I know you've won a championship here in this building, and Cheryl, you've got a couple gold medals and a few world championships as well. Can you put into words maybe what some of these players are feeling right now?
You know, it was 21 years ago when I was here with the St. John Flames and they won the Calder Trophy here. Somehow it feels bigger. It feels a little more dear to the people of St. John. And when you watch the enthusiasm of the kids and what they went through, our team was terrific and everything, but it feels different and it feels bigger. And, you know, it does, I think, when you see the fans take it all in and the joy on the players' faces, I mean, that to me is what it's all about. And it just brings back goosebumps for me, to be straightforward.
Well, it really does. In the dying seconds of the game, you know, your hair was standing on end because you just knew the feeling on one side. Of course, it's not a great one. And on the other, it's a feeling that you're never going to forget. And you think about everything that these athletes went through. I mean, through the pandemic and finding ways to be resilient, to train, to keep their passion and their dream alive, and then to realize it today with their teammates, their families, their friends. It's something, an emotion that they certainly will never forget and they'll carry with them for the rest of their lives.
Well, they leave their homes, most of them at 16 years of age, and they become part of the community. And the community takes them in, whether it be in the schools, whether it be in the charity work they do, and they grow up, and they grow up together. And it's really special now when you achieve together. But Cheryl, you know this, that's forever.
And it is a bond you have forever. So in 20 years' time, 30 years' time, 40 years' time, they will always have a bond, a connection that you see right now with this celebration photo and how unbelievable it is. And it might be a phone call in 30 years. It might be a friendship that continues to last. But it is a bond. It is an unbreakable bond when you go through this together and you're victorious.
And a big props to head coach Gardner McDougal as well. He took over this team May 24th, just a little over a month ago. And you know, he's one of the winningest coaches in Canadian university sports history. University of New Brunswick, over two decades there, seven national championships. And he said, I know how important it is to this community to get a win like this and how it's a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to be coaching in a scenario like this, Craig.
Do you remember what we talked about right at the beginning of this tournament? We talked about Gardner McDougal. We said all he does is win. and win, right? Like, I mean, and he said, I'm coming here to win the Memorial Cup. I'm not coming here to coach.
Well, and Lady Mo, Lady Mo. And you know, you also have to talk about the trust and the belief that that group had in his vision, the execution of the game plan, whether it was a neutral zone, the speed. They bought into his plan. He's an inspirer. He's a motivator. And you can see it right from the goaltender right out.
And here comes the Gatorade. Oh, yeah.
Celebrations continue here for your 2022 Memorial Cup champions, the St. John Sea Dogs. Speaking of Gardner McDougal, he is standing by with Julia.
Gardner, you got to the rink really early today and you went for a walk around. Did you see Lady Luck or Lady Mo?
I think we had both of them tonight. Yeah, unbelievable. And along with those two, we had the best fans in the country here tonight. Unbelievable atmosphere, just doesn't get any better.
I heard you say earlier this tournament that sometimes it's necessary to lose to win. What do you think losing in the first round did for this team's motivation?
The biggest thing is just the separation. How we felt after the first game was unbelievable after being off for 39 days. And the acceleration of winning a game in the Memorial Cup against a really good opponent. And then losing a heartbreaker, just a separation. We're fortunate we had a couple of days off. Played a really good Quebec Major Junior Champion in Shawinigan. And obviously the comeback was a difference maker for our team. There's a lot of belief. And then tonight, scored first, got the crowd behind us, and just kept getting better as the game went.
It's been a weird year. It's been a weird couple of years. Did you ever picture yourself as the only coach to win a university title and a CHL title in the same season?
Unbelievable. Yeah, I'm glad I answered the phone.
Congratulations.
Thank
Winnipeg
you very
Jets
much.
Next.
Yeah, excellent.
We saw earlier Gardner McDougal. He's done that a few times in his life, and hasn't he brought this group together at the right time as everybody in the front office and all the people that it requires to come together to win a championship like this, one they'll never forget. A memorable night in the 102nd. There it is, champion of the Memorial Cup.
Of course, the head coach, Gardner McDougal, with his assistants, Travis Crickard, Stephen Legion, goalie coach, Brian Fleming, GM and president, Trevor George, assistant GM, Anthony Stella, Terry Blizzard, conditioning coach, equipment manager, Tyler Jay, physical therapist, Jeff Kelly, and William DeFore's mom on the ice, as well as the friends and family will join the players and staff on the ice for the St. John Sea Dogs to share this special moment.
Better every day was the model, wasn't it, from Gardner and the general manager, Trevor Georgie. There he gets the wetsuit, and now he gets to hoist that cup over his head. Better every day. They certainly lived up to that motto as they were the better team in the last day, crowned champions.
Well, this has been one of the most extraordinary seasons in the history of the Canadian Hockey League. At the end of it all, it's the St. John Sea Dogs on top. There is the owner, Scott McCain from Florenceville, New Brunswick, hoists the Memorial Cup trophy in his home province as owner of St. John.
From frozen rinks to frozen snowbanks to center ice here in St. John as a very proud owner and now a champion.
Well, for final thoughts on this game, we'll send it back over to the panel with Laura Dykin.
And with that, it's a wrap on the 2022 Memorial Cup presented by Kia. A big thank you to everyone here at St. John, New Brunswick, for making this experience so, so memorable. And thanks to all the viewers for watching along with us. And congratulations to the 2022 champs, the St. John Sea Dogs.
Nearly 40 days ago, the lowest of the low for the St. John Sea Dogs players. They had been bounced from the first round of the Q playoffs, but a coaching change and four more games have made all the difference as pure joy now for the Sea Dogs. Here is how it all unfolded tonight. Memorial Cup final. St. John looking to raise junior hockey's most coveted trophy for the first time since 2011, while Hamilton looking to win their first Memorial Cup in franchise history early in the first. William Villeneuve finds Vincent Savigny, and he scores on the first shot of the game. The hosts on the board just 2.5 minutes into the opening frame, and they were just getting started. A few minutes later, it's more from Villeneuve. Great feed to Cam McDonald in front. Cam spins and buries it. The Maple Leafs prospect with the second assist of the period. Sea Dogs score twice in 3 minutes. They have a 2-0 lead. We're still in the frame. Pass from Mason McTavish is broken up. Logan Morrison finds Nathan Stales at the point. His shot tipped in by McTavish. First of two goals in this one for 2021's third overall pick. The Bulldogs are down 2-1 at the break. Let's go early second period. McDonald plays it ahead to Riley Bizzo, and he's going to wire it past Marco Costantini. First of the tournament for Bizzo, and that restores a two-goal lead for the Sea Dogs. And then we get more Sea Dogs.
Here comes Ryan Francis, hits the line with speed. Francis to the outside, circles the net.
The seventh of the tournament, continuing to light the lamp after an historic four-goal performance versus Shawinigan on Saturday. Sea Dogs up 4-2, and we're going to the final frame. On the power play in the third, Dufour finds Josh Lawrence, and Josh Lawrence puts this one away. Second at the tournament for the 20-year-old. That's going to make it 5-2 Sea Dogs. And frustration building for the Bulldogs. The Memorial Cup coming out for the 102nd time.
Scott McCain and Trevor Georgie joined forces. It was all about bringing the Memorial Cup back to St. John. Years later, this Maritime Memorial Cup dream is a reality. St. John are Memorial Cup champions in 2022.
The St. John Sea Dogs are your 2022 Memorial Cup champs. They defeat the Hamilton Bulldogs to capture their second Memorial Cup in franchise history. Sea Dogs captain Vincent Sevigné receives the cup, and let the celebrations begin. Gardner McDougall, legendary coach of the University of New Brunswick. He's won 7 national championships in 22 years at the helm of the men's program, and now he will add a Memorial Cup to his resume as he was the interim coach of the St. John Sea Dogs, and they are Memorial Cup champs. They pick up their second title in 4 Memorial Cup tournament appearances, and their first since 2011. Also, the first host to win the Memorial Cup since Windsor in 2017. With much more, back to St. John we go. Laura Dykin and our Memorial Cup panel.
Thank you. Join alongside Cheryl Pounder as well as Craig Button as the celebrations continue here behind us with the St. John Sea Dogs. And talk about your storybook ending. This was a team that was one of the hottest groups in the QMJHL down the stretch. They won their last 15 regular season games. Expectations were high going into the playoffs, but they stumbled, getting knocked out in the first round to Rimouski. Then they make a coaching change. They bring in Gardner McDougall. They hadn't played a single game since May the 12th. They were a huge wild card coming into this 102nd Memorial Cup. And now we get our storybook ending.
1,127 days between the last Memorial Cup that was presented. And it must have felt that long for the St. John Sea Dogs waiting for this Memorial Cup to begin. A great run down the stretch, as you point out, Laura. And then the upset to the Rimouski Oceanic. And, you know, you go through that first of disbelief and that this really happened to us, because the St. John Sea Dogs were a good team in that league and into the playoffs. And then you get upset. But then Gardner McDougall comes in, and Gardner McDougall got them on track. And you talk about game plan and buying in, Cheryl, it's exactly what they did.
Well, he's a motivator. He's an inspirer. He has such a pedigree, a history of winning. And he comes into this organization, and he really shows that. I mean, the structure that this team had, the ability to close down the neutral zone right from the get-go, and their speed as well, the way they entered. There was a sense of belief, a sense of trust within this dressing room that they just knew. They had, you know, unfinished business for sure, yeah. But with guys like William DeFore and company, this team certainly set out on a mission.
This was like the ultimate second chance, the ultimate mulligan, and they don't come around all the time. You mentioned William DeFore. When we look back at this Memorial Cup, the St. John Sea Dogs will be right in the middle of some of the biggest moments. First 3-on-3 overtime round robin in Memorial Cup history, and then that huge comeback on Saturday. They were down 3-0 to Shawinigan going into the second period. They needed a win in regulation in order to make it through and get this bye straight here to Wednesday final. DeFore was the QMJHL's MVP. He was just named the Memorial Cup MVP. 4 goals in that game, but he's not just a one-trick pony, is he?
Well, he's not. I mean, he did everything. He certainly put the team on his back, and he said, "You coming along with me?" He had 4 goals in that game. I mean, not just a goal scorer here, but of course, as you mentioned, Laura, the MVP in the Q, where he had 116 points on the season. But the ability to release, I mean, the quick release, his habits. I mean, he was on the PK in that game, and he started it right from there. His drive to the net to get to the mid lane of the ice, not afraid to get gritty, to get dirty, and then of course to play along the wall, play below the goal line, and get to the soft spot. This is a guy that really wanted to take control, and he certainly did, and nothing is more significant than that and hoisting that trophy, Craig.
Well, you know, we know what he did on the ice. We know what he did with those goal-scoring exploits. But he was really the emotional barometer for this yep. team. I mean, in that game that they were down 3-0 to Shawinigan on Saturday, they had nothing going, not a thing going. And shorthanded, Cheryl, he literally just said, "I'm taking this game by the scruff of its neck." And he shook it until it went their way, and he never stopped. And then he came into this game the exact same way, with that determination, and he said, follow me. I'm the guy. You know, there was fog here in St. John yesterday, right? And you look to a lighthouse to try to give you your bearings. William Dufour was the lighthouse for the St. John Sea Dogs.
Yeah, he certainly was. Just the habits all around the ice. Just incredible.
And that is a wrap on the 2022 Memorial Cup presented by Kia. A big thanks to all the volunteers, the city of St. John, our hardworking crew. They worked tirelessly to make us look good. And, of course, the fans for following along with us. The parade is set for Thursday. I think the celebration.